Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm finishing up talking about multiplying polynomials and then starting into division with polynomials. We don't do a lot in this particular class with dividing, but just a little touch on it. So the special products, I wanted to do one more of those that had more than one variable in it. The thing that I mentioned before is you can use the shortcut or you could rewrite your second power problem and just write it out and use the FOIL. So either one works for me, works for you, whatever works for you, I should say. The rule was that it's going to be a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So I can use that shortcut or I could FOIL it. Let's see what I get if I FOIL 5x times 5x is 25x squared. Outsides, I get 15xy. Inside, though, I get the same thing. That's why it's doubled down here, because you're going to get the same thing twice. And then 3y times 3y is 9y squared. Now, if I combine those like terms, I get 25x squared. These two become 15 and 15 is 30xy, and then 9y squared. And that's my final answer. And you can look at the shortcut would have been 5x times 5x, 25x squared. And then you multiply these two things together. That's 15xy doubled. That's 30xy. And then you double the, or multiply this times itself. 3y times 3y is 9y squared. Okay, now the last one, what if you have something like this? Well, you want to do this part first, and then you want to do this part. So remember, if I have a binomial squared with a minus, it just changes the minus sign there in the front. So I'm going to square 5y. 5y times 5y is 25y squared. Then I'm going to multiply these two terms together. Negative 5 times 5y is negative 25y. Double it, negative 50y. And then negative 5 times negative 5 is positive 25. So I used the shortcut to do that one, but I could have written it out and FOILed it. And now that I've done that, I'm going to distribute my monomial through there. 25 times 2 is 50. I have y to the first and y to the second. Add those together to get y to the third. And then I have 2y times negative 50y. 2 times negative 50 is negative 100. And 1 plus 1 gives me y squared. And then I have 2y times 25, which is 50. And then I have the y that's still on there. And then I'm finished. So I need to FOIL that out or multiply that binomial out and then distribute the 2 that was in front of it. Okay, this one says, find the polynomial that represents the volume of a cube if each side measures x plus 2. So when you think about a cube, I'm not very good at drawing them, so give me a break. But if this was a cube, then all the sides would be the same, right? So I'd have this is x plus 2, this is x plus 2. And this is x plus 2, the height, the width, and the length. There's three different dimensions. And so what I'm actually saying is x plus 2 to the third power, right? Because all those three things, because the volume is length times width times height, okay? And all of our length and width or height are the same here. So it's that thing to the third power. So I'm going to start off with x plus 2 to the second power, and then I'll multiply that times x to the second, I mean x plus 2. Using my shortcut here, I'm actually going to put the x plus 2 on the front here. Now I'm going to square this using this rule up here. So I have x to the second power. Multiply the 2 together gives me 2x, and double it gives me 4x. And then square the last term, 2 times 2 is 4. So I multiplied the first two, and now I've got to multiply that whole thing by x plus 2. And that we did before in the last video. And if I take x times x, I get x to the third. X times 4x, I get 4x to the second. I'm just adding my powers as I go here, right? And x times 4 gives me 4x. Now I'm going to go back and say 2 times x squared, 2 times 4x, and 2 times 4. So I'm ready to combine those like terms like I did before, and that gives me x to the third plus 6x to the second plus 12x plus 8. So that would be the, this represents the volume. I can call that volume if I want. Then that's the polynomial, though, that would represent the volume of that cube. Okay, I don't know if I talked about this before, so I want to say, I'm saying remember, but maybe I'm saying new. I can't remember. But anyway, if you have the same base in a fraction, different powers on top and bottom, the rule is you can just subtract those exponents. So in other words, if you had x to the 10 over x to the second, that would be x to the 10 minus 2 or x to the 8th. Because basically these two x's will cancel two of the x's up above, but there'd be 8 left over. So that's a little shortcut. So if you're asked to simplify something like this, then you think of it as two separate parts. You got your number part, 10 divided by 5 is 2, and then you have your variable part. You had 5 on top, and you canceled 3 of those, or 5 minus 3, and that leaves y squared. If you have something like number 19, where you have two terms up there, you have to think of it as two separate problems. You have y to the fifth over y, and then y to the second over y. It goes under both of those terms. So then you say, if I have 5 and I subtract 1, that leaves y to the fourth. And if I have 2 and I subtract 1, that leaves just y. And there's my answer. I can't combine those any further because they have different degrees. So number 20, I'm going to do x to the 7th over 2x to the 3rd minus 4x to the 3rd over 2x to the 3rd. Well, I have a coefficient of 1 on the top, even though I didn't see it. But I know that if I can't do anything with 1 half, I still have 1 half as my answer. But I also know that I can simplify the x parts by subtracting my powers. 7 minus 3 is x to the 4th power. If you think I'm going too fast, then you need to pause it, write down, catch up. The thing about taking an early math class is that you learn skills that are going to help you be successful in later math classes. And so you want to learn note-taking. And you want to be able to write down without having to look at everything, but just listen and write some things. Or in this case, if you can't do it, you pause it, you write, you'll get faster as time goes on. And now I'm going to divide 4 by 2, and that gives me 2. And then I have 3 on top and 3 on the bottom. So those cancel out altogether, and I don't have any variable part left there. I just have 1 half x to the 4th minus 2. All right, and finally, number 21, if you haven't done any of these on your own, maybe you want to try pausing and try this on your own. I've got three parts here, negative 16b to the 4th over negative 2b squared, 10b to the 3rd over negative 2b squared. Be sure and write your signs in there. 4b squared over negative 2b squared. And so I have to simplify those three parts. Notice in the first one I've got two negatives. That's going to become a positive. 16 divided by 2 is 8. And I have 4 minus 2 or b squared. In my second one, I have a positive divided by a negative, so that becomes a negative. 10 divided by 2 is 5, and I have 3 minus 2, or b to the first power. Again, I don't need to show that 1 there for that first power. And here I have 2 negatives, so that's going to be a plus. 4 divided by 2 is 2, and the b's cancel out completely. 2 minus 2 is 0, so those are gone, and this is going to be my final answer. All right. We'll see you next time. Have a fantastic day.